Hello everyone, I'm Franco, your TAMIU ARC graduate writing consultant, and today we're writing discussion board posts, everybody's favorite. In 3 minutes, I'm going to be teaching you about how you can save your college discussion board posts formatting using just a little coding magic. Now please, before you get terrified because you don't know anything about coding and you thought getting your degree was already hard enough without having to learn a skill completely unrelated to your degree, take a deep breath. We're going to take this easy. Remember, learning new skills, especially technology skills, is really useful, and hopefully you'll be able to carry these little tricks with you long after you stop writing discussion board posts for your college class. So here's the problem. You're a student writing discussion board posts for your class online, and you find that the formatting that you carefully crafted for your well-written response is less than what you wanted it to be. What's worse, formatting errors like single space lines, unitalized words, or paragraphs that are not aligned correctly can actually end up losing you points in your writing, no matter how hard you try to format them, depending on what your professor is looking for. Discussion board posts are getting better at having editing toolbars that you can use to correct those little issues, but there are still some things that they haven't caught up with. So how do you fix that? Well, we're going to fix that using HTML source code. HTML source code can let you change all sorts of visual settings for your text, from changing the font size, the font type, making it bold, italics, underline, even changing its color in some cases. If you have no experience with HTML code at all, one way to think of it is to picture the screen on your web browser as something like a stage play, where all the actors, which are your words and images, are putting on costumes, receiving directions from people working backstage, all that sort of thing. But you only see the front of it. When you open up your source code, that's the stuff here, you're going to be looking at the back, what's going on backstage, and manipulating that. So here's a sample of discussion board posts that I'm trying to submit that needs to be an APA 7 format. It isn't quite right. See how my source code has some HTML already working for it? And here's a discussion board post I'm submitting that is in proper APA 7. Look at all that code. How can you make heads or tails of it, much less make it work for you? Well, let me break down some of the most useful bits here. HTML uses tags, which are placed inside of these triangular brackets. When you put certain words inside these brackets, you create a tag, which is sort of like a specific direction for your code to follow. In other words, anything placed in these brackets will become code. When you combine these tags with the text that you want to put down, that's called an element. Here are some simple tags. This one is bold. This one is italicized. This one creates a subscript. This one makes your text superscript. To make a script run, you need both a starting tag like these, plus words, then ending with a corresponding end tag, which tells the code when to stop. End tags look similar to tags, but they have a slash line, such as this one, and so on. Remember, you have to place your text like this in the source code for it to work. Simply copying all of this into your text box won't do anything unless you have the source code pulled up and HTML enabled. There are dozens of available HTML tags, but for today, we're just going to learn a few more. This one defines a paragraph of text. This one creates a line break, similar to the Enter key on a keyboard. This one through this one create different sizes of headings, each bigger than the last, which is good for making titles for your paper. This or this creates bold text. This or this creates italics or emphasized text. This creates block quotes, which can have varying sizes and dimensions depending on the kind of web browser that you're using. Let's try it. So now you know a little about how to mess with the format settings for things that you write where HTML is enabled. But you might notice that the discussion board post I'm submitting still is missing some of the elements required for proper APA citation formatting. In part two of this, I'm going to show you how to continue adjusting your text formatting using CSS styles to get your writing just right. Thank you for watching. Subscribe to TAMIU ARC's YouTube channel for more videos about writing, research, and other things graduate students need to know to be successful. See the description for more information on HTML as well. Stay smart and visit ARC.